a dire warning on climate change.
You're battling Mother Nature, you're likely to lose.
The damage is particularly devastating for farmers.
Irreversible damage.
The worst flooding in a lifetime.
Nearly a million species are at risk of extinction.
Earth is an ocean planet. The ocean covers most of the Earth's surface, and it has shaped humanity since the beginning. Now, looking forward, the ocean will be central to understand human-driven changes in climate and the environment.
The ocean does two important things. It absorbs heat, slowing the warming of the air. It also absorbs the carbon dioxide from fossil fuel burning. Eventually, the ocean is where almost all of this carbon will go, to be stored in deep waters and stabilized by reactions with limestone sediments on the seafloor. Simply put, the ocean is the global environment's most important buffer against these human-driven changes.
So the ocean is a buffer for climate, but this great service comes at a price. The absorption of heat, of CO2, combines with other human impacts, such as nutrient pollution, to drive major changes in the patterns and diversity of marine life. Coastal nations and communities are at greater risk, but eventually it will impact everyone.
Looking out decades into the future, it is not yet clear how the ocean will respond. Will carbon uptake accelerate or stall out? Will marine ecosystems and fisheries prove resilient, or will they collapse?
At Princeton and the Princeton Environmental Institute, we are tackling these questions comprehensively, looking at the present, the past, and the future. We are developing new measurement tools and computational tools to study the modern ocean.
We are looking into the ocean's past with cores from sediments, corals, and ice to put current changes into perspective.
And we are simulating future ocean changes with computer models of global climate.
Our work so far has revealed ocean responses to climate that we did not anticipate. This highlights for us the need to improve our understanding of the ocean before we can have confidence in predictions of its changes under future global warming.
So up to this point, our focus has been on global ocean changes, but as our tools are improving, we are beginning to investigate how individual regions, nations, and communities will be affected.